Not a good plan.
Guys, the world is falling apart. Welcome back to That Dog Spot. There is a large percentage of you guys who have not subscribed to the channel yet. You are still watching the video, so please subscribe. Click the bell icon, which will help you out because you get notifications every single time I upload a video. I upload a video every single week, sometimes more than that, if I feel like it. We're going to cover how to extend a studio backdrop in Photoshop. Like you guys in the last video saw a little bit of my personality come out, and this is how I get, especially when it's sunny. It is a beautiful day today, but my life is a bit sad because we are locked down. My whole season is cancelled and my free time got slightly bigger. So I'm going to carry on making these videos. You stick what you want to see in the comments below. In this video, what we're going to do is we're going to look at a picture that I took of a dog in studio. Picture will be on the screen now. I'm going to have already done all of my basic edits in Lightroom. If you're wondering how to edit a studio photo in Lightroom, let me know and I'll do a tutorial. To cover off this tutorial, we're going to switch over to the Mac. I'm going to record the screen and you are not going to see my face. So let's go and do that right now. This is the image that we're going to be working on today. This is Alfie. So we've got this picture, we've done our Lightroom base edits, and then we've got this situation and this situation, along with this situation, all of this stuff. What we're going to be looking at today is how to extend thy backdrop to obliterate this, which lets you take pictures like this in smaller spaces. So the first thing that I'm going to do is I'm going to do a super quick cleanup of the backdrop by using a spot healing tool to clean it up. If you don't know what I'm talking about, look to the link at the top of the screen. So once I've done that, I'm going to go ahead and grab my rectangular marquee tool that lives over here. If you can't see it, right click, pick the rectangular marquee tool or press M. What you want to do is you want to click and drag from right at the top to right at the bottom, and you want to go right to the edge of your subject like so. Then what we're going to do is we're going to go into edit and choose the content aware scale. Click on that. If you want a new version of the CC, you're going to want to be holding down the shift key whilst you pull, which will just pull like this. If you didn't do that, you would be pulling like this. If your screen does this when you press the shift key, don't press the shift key. Click and drag all the way to the end of the screen and double click just like that. You've got a full backdrop. Now at this side, we've got a little bit more problems to work with because we have a foot over it and shadow. What we're going to do is we're going to do this in little baby steps. And first of all, I'm going to just remove the leg. Doesn't have to be pretty, doesn't have to be perfect. The aim is to just remove the general leg. Then, same thing, you want to be clicking like that. But oh look, you've only got this big. So what we're going to do is we're going to go like this to the edge of the dog, and then edit content aware scale, hold shift if your computer does that, and click and drag. Again, doesn't need to be pretty. At this stage, what we're doing is we're just scaling up areas of the image that we can later use. When you're in a situation where you've just got this little gap, things start to get a bit tricky. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna rectangular marquee off a whole load of this space at this side. Then what we're going to do is we're going to do Control or Command plus C, which basically is copy, and then Control or Command V, which is paste. Then what we're going to do is we're going to do a Control or Command and T, which is transform. I'm going to right click and flip horizontal. Then we're going to drag our new background bit over this area of the image. Doesn't have to be super precise at the moment, and double click to lock that in. Then we're going to mask. If you don't know how to mask, check out my other video. And then we're going to grab the brush tool, nice and big, nice and soft, and we're going to start to, on a opposite brush, so black, at 100% opacity, we're going to start to erase the area that our subject is sat in. like so. And just like that, you've filled it in. You can go ahead, fine tune around the area of your subject. Once you're happy, right click on the layer and do merge down. Now what we can also do is just drop back this area where it's overexposed, where it's blown. So I'm going to go on my burn tool. I'm going to keep it on the highlights for now. Just do a few dots. It's looking green. We'll assess. And then mid-tones to just drop that off like so. And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to use the colour from over here with the eyedropper tool. And then use a brush, big brush, on about 10 to 20%. I'm going to use 20%. And I'm just going to add that colour down here. It's a bit flat. I'm going to use a brighter version of this yellow. And just dot that in. I'm going to show you before and after. Now, if you weren't a perfectionist, you could just stop right there, but I am a perfectionist, so I'm going to be using my clone stamp tool, nice and big. I'm going to pick an area, doesn't matter where that area is, as long as it is not near an edge, cannot be near an edge. And then at a low opacity, we're at 30% here, I'm just going to start dotting this over the curve crease. Once you're happy with that, we're going to go in and fine-tune areas of the creases. As I always say, anywhere in the image that is the brightest part, aka right here, that's going to draw your eye. So we need to drop that down a touch. Burn tool on highlights, very low exposure on this, and just dot. Don't overdo it, just dot. I'm going to just go over right in, we're at 300% here, and I'm just going to clean up his face. And then a levels check, as always, Command or Control plus L. You want to be holding down the Alt key and bringing that in. Anywhere that's gone black, we've lost the blacks. I'm going to keep it about there. And then the highlights, anywhere that is white, as it were, we've lost two highlights. So if I were to let go, that would look like this, which is pretty bad. So we're just going to go ahead and stop about there. Barely tell, but you can still tell. Fine tune my colour. I'm going to go ahead into yellows, and then move the hue. Beautiful. And that's it. Job done.
I appreciate audience participation, so if you've got something you would like to say, please make it be nice. Drop it in the comments below, or send me a message on Facebook, or just send a carrier pigeon. I can't save you from a virus, but I can help you improve your photography, so please subscribe.
Subscribe to my YouTube channel. I'm going to take my tea and walk away.